You're watching a production of South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
This high school activities championship event is conducted under the auspices of the South Dakota High School Activities Association.
Hello and welcome to the Premier Center in Sioux Falls. With Craig Maddock from Sioux Falls Sports Radio, KWSN, I'm Mike Henriksen from Sports Max Radio and Calling All Sports. Welcome to Championship Night as we break in a brand new building with its first state championship in basketball. Craig, very exciting action going on around the state of South Dakota, up in Aberdeen and in Rapid City.
State B's in Aberdeen tonight, third place. It's going to be Hitchcock Gilaire, who shocked the Class B world when they knocked off number one Faith. They'll take on the White River for third place. And then Hanson and Lankford going at it for the B championship.
I'm sure the Barnett Center will be rocking. And out west in Rapid City.
Top seed, Aberdeen Roncalli. Number three seed, Dells. Those two teams played each other earlier in the year. I think Aberdeen Roncalli won that one.
They did. They picked up a victory in that one. So it is a rematch. Meanwhile, Little Wound and Winter going at it for third place this evening. And again, those tournaments are available on SDPB 2 and 3.
Right here on SDPB 1.
Yep, we've got Rapid City Stevens and Sioux Falls of Gorman. And then the nightcap, Washington and Lincoln.
Let's take a look at the matchups tonight. First, the O'Gorman Knights. O'Gorman, the number three seed. Boy, what a double overtime thriller they had last night, as they're located right there at the corner of 41st and Kiwanis.
There you see royal blue and white, one of the smallest of the big schools. That happens each and every year. How did they get here?
They won the district.
They defeated Brookings and defeated Watertown. They picked up a very tight win over Pierre on Thursday, and last night, double overtime, they lost to Sioux Falls Lincoln.
One change in the lineup tonight. Jacob Fleck will get the start. The senior going to get the chance to go tonight instead of Antonio Cassiella. But we'll still see Antonio a lot. But Braxton Elliott, what a night he had last night. He's averaging 30 in the last two games.
He has been amazing to watch. Meanwhile, for Rapid City Stevens, let's head to the opposite side of the state. Out in the edge of the beautiful Black Hills of Dakota, Rapid City Stevens, the Raiders come in tonight.
Third straight appearance to the AA tournament. Rapid City Stevens got here by winning at District 4, Spearfish in Central. And then at the state tournament on Thursday, they beat Aberdeen Central, but then lost last night to number one seed Sioux Falls, Washington.
And of course, the very familiar silver and blue of Rapid City Stevens. Taking a look at their starting lineups, they will go with Brad Drake, Mason Archambault, Wyatt Ostis, J.J. Cunningham, and a player that could be player of the year in South Dakota, Sam McLeod. He was effectively contained last night by Sioux Falls, Washington.
But he's been averaging 21 points a game, only 10 points a game, though, in this state tournament.
And meanwhile, Mason Archambault, one of the most electric sophomores that you will see in the state of South Dakota as well. There you get a look at Ron Reihard, the head coach. He took over this year. It is his first year, but he is a long, long time coach. This is just first year for that program. Derek Roby is in his 10th year as the head coach of the O'Gorman Knights. They had an amazing run of titles. They have won five titles, and they did them all in the aughts. They have been away for a while, but they are back and playing for third place. So tonight, let's get things underway. It's championship night at the Premier Center in Sioux Falls. Let's turn it over to our PA announcer.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Denny Sanford Premier Center and this final session of the state AA boys basketball tournament. The South Dakota High School Activities Association, along with its corporate partners, Sanford Health, First Premier Bank, Premier Bank Card, Farmers Union Insurance Agency, Billion Automotive, and the South Dakota Army National Guard, welcome you to this session of the state AA boys basketball tournament. Tonight, we shall crown the 30th state champion for Class AA boys basketball. Carrying the South Dakota High School Activities Association banner onto the courts are Rachel Fredenberg and Katie Mertens of Roosevelt High School. Now, let's meet our tournament teams, beginning with the teams that played this afternoon in the first game. The Tigers of Huron High School, carrying their school colors, is Quincy Giller. And the Arrows of Watertown High School. Their school colors are carried by Jenna Hansen. In the Consolation Championship game were the Golden Eagles of Aberdeen Central High School. Brooklyn Fouth is carrying the school colors. And the Governors of Pierre T.F. Riggs High School. Carrying the school colors is Brittany Fadul. In this evening's first game, playing for the third and fourth places are the Raiders of Rapid City Stevens High School. Carrying their school colors is Nova Vollmer. And the Knights of Sioux Falls O'Gorman High School. Megan Hayes is carrying the school colors. And in the championship game tonight, we have the Warriors of Sioux Falls Washington High School. Anna Odins is carrying the school colors. And their opponents, the Patriots of Sioux Falls Lincoln High School. Katie Strandy is carrying the flag. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please now continue to stand as members of the Pine Ridge Junior ROTC present the flag of our country. Members of the color guard include, in the honor guard, Jacob Sorbell. Carrying the national colors, Savannah Ghost Dog. Carrying the South Dakota state colors, Kristen Big Crow. Carrying the Ogallala tribal colors, Peyton One Feather. Carrying the Pine Ridge JROTC colors, Fallen Sorbell. And in the honor guard, Dakota Big Crow. Tonight, our national anthem will be played by the Brandon Valley Anthem Trumpets, under the direction of Jesse Miller. We remind everyone that the proper respect is to remove your hat, face the flag, and stand at attention with your right hand over your heart. Veterans and active duty military not in uniform may salute the flag. Ladies and gentlemen, our national anthem. Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the final session of the 2015 State AA Boys Basketball Tournament. Each year, the South Dakota High School Activities Association sponsors statewide events in athletics, journalism, music, and speech activities. The Activities Association, along with its corporate partners, Sanford Health, First Premier Bank, Premier Bank Card, Farmers Union Insurance Agency, Billion Automotive, and the South Dakota Army National Guard, believe that these athletic and fine arts activities provide lessons for life, including the lessons taught with good sportsmanship. We hope that you enjoy tonight's state tournament games and that you let your good sportsmanship show. At this basketball game for third place, featuring the Knights from Sioux Falls O'Gorman and the Raiders from Rapid City Stevens. Now let's meet our starting lineup, introduced alternately, and beginning with the O'Gorman Knights. Starting at a guard, a 6'3" senior, number 3, Braxton Elliott. And starting at a guard for the Raiders, a 5'10" senior, number 2, Brad Drake. Starting at a guard for the Knights, a 6-foot senior, number 10, Jacob Fleck. And starting at a guard for the Raiders, a 5'11" sophomore, number 10, Mason Archambault. Starting at a forward for the Knights, a 6'6" senior, number 20, Davis Cowan. And starting at a forward for the Raiders, a 6'2" senior, number 23, J.J. Cunningham. Starting at a forward for the Knights, a 6'5" junior, number 31, Jack Geary. And starting at a forward for the Raiders, a 6'6" senior, number 25, Sam McLeod. And starting at center for the O'Gorman Knights, a 6'6" junior, number 33, Ben Lauer. And starting at center for the Rapid City Stevens Raiders, a 6'6" senior, number 32, Wyatt Astis. Assistant coaches for the O'Gorman Knights are Steve Creer, BJ Kippen, Mike Newfield, and Blake Bradfield. Head coach of the O'Gorman Knights is Derek Roby. Assistant coaches for the Stevens Raiders are Adam Dannenbrink, Jason Olson, Kevin Budwell, and Quincy Oliver. Head coach is Ron Reihard. The officials for this game, as assigned by the South Dakota High School Activities Association, are Fran Rusink, Jeremy Grady, and Lee Johnson. Our alternate official is Luke Langer.
And so we are set to go. The Raiders and the Knights. Lauer will jump it up against Sam McLeod. Fran Rusink puts it in the air, and we are underway.
Third meeting of the year. Two times in the regular season, the Knights won both of them.
Jacob Fleck with the basketball, gives it up to Elliott. Jumper, no good. Rebound McLeod. Look for the Raiders to try to get McLeod involved in the offense early. We said in the pregame he was effectively stifled last night.
Well, last two nights, Sam has had a tough go. He averages 21 points a game. He's averaged only 10 as they tried to go the lob to McLeod.
Archambault just a little bit off, well defended by the Knights. Working the perimeter, now down low to Lauer on the low block. Reverse it. Jumper up and good. Davis Cowan with the three.
That's his fourth one of the tournament. Gets the Knights the lead.
There's a steal by Cowan. Callen into the front court. Cut off there by J.J. Cunningham. Had it stripped by Cunningham. Ball loose on the floor. Jump ball. Alternating possession. It will belong to the Stevens Raiders.
Rapid City Stevens averaging about 54 points a game. They're defensively giving up about 54 a game. This is a team offensively. They want McLeod to be the leading scorer, but they got Archambault at number 10 and Brad Drake, number 2. He had a good day on Thursday.
There's the drive by Drake, puts it up too strong. Rebound by Davis Cullen. Up ahead to Elliott. Elliott drops it off for Lauer, and it's taken away by Ostis. Into the front court, Cunningham. He'll take it. Baseline jumper rolls around, no good, and Lauer with the rebound.
Braxton Elliott with the ball. He's averaging 30 points a game. He had a monster game in that game against Lincoln last night. One of the top double-A performances that we have seen in a long time now.
It was. He was just incredible. And even when you knew he was going to take the shot, he was still making the shot.
He went for 35 last night with 6 threes.
Had 25 on opening night. Archambault into the front court.
Got to get McLeod some touches. See if he feels it.
Cross court, Cunningham, Ostis.
Knights are keeping Peary on McLeod.
McLeod will take the long three, front of the rim. No good, rebound Cowan.
Three steps behind the three-point arc. Don't know if you really want to take that one.
Elliott to the hole, no good, but he'll step to the line and shoot two. Foul is going to go on Sam McLeod. Sam picked up two quick ones on Thursday and did not pick up his third in that first half, was able to play through it, but last night was severely limited by foul trouble.
Knights bring in four fresh players. They bring in Luke Fritsch, J.P. Costello, Antonio Cassiello, and they bring in Jimmy Burma.
And another Knight player will be coming in if this shot is made. It is.
Coach Roby going with the 5-on-5. He did this at the beginning of the season as they bring in Ethan French. Looked like a hockey change about every 3 minutes.
J.J. Watson in the ball game for the Raiders.
Last game of the year, have some fun with it. Be competitive, get guys on the court, make it a memorable evening.
Ethan French. Go over to Antonio Cassiello. Jimmy Burma not able to hold on. Archambault, the name is familiar. His dad is Russ Archambault. May remember Russ. Russ is from, I think, Fort Yates in North Dakota, just across the border. Ball goes out of bounds and we'll step aside. I'll finish up that thought when we come back. You're watching the Class AA Championships on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. With Craig Maddock, I'm Mike Henriksen. O'Gorman Knights with the basketball and the lead. Back to Archambault. His dad, Russ Archambault, played at the University of Minnesota and then transferred to Huron College, Santa Gliska.
By the way, this is the third game in a row in the tournament. The Knights have gone off to a 5-0 lead. At least a 5-0 lead in each of the three tournament games.
KJ Watson. Jumper up and good. Wyatt Ostis with the three. Frank Cassiello. Jumper put up, no good. Ball was tipped around, and Watson comes up with it. Gives it off to Archambault. Archambault on the opening day was scoreless in the first half and then went for 16 in the second half. McLeod, nice drop pass back to Austis. Archambault can't hit the three, and the Knights will walk it into the front court. That's Luke Fritsch. Fritsch gives it up to French. That's not easy to say. I hope those two don't pass the ball to each other all night long. French back around to J.P. Costello, the 6'5 sophomore. Leave it for Burma. Double clutches, gets it off. Ball stripped away. Here comes McLeod. Cassiello knocks it away. Can't save it, however. And the Knights will go back to their starting lineup.
Yeah, both teams are going to go pretty deep on the bench. Rapid City, Stevens, they're going to bring in... They bring in Andrew Mardian. Also back in Sam... Let's see, McLeod will stay in.
Yep.
J.J. Cunningham is back in.
Chris James is the other one that came in. Archambault will key it in. Gets it into Cunningham.
Wyatt Austis is going to the locker room. He's got some blood. Mike, he's going to be number 50 when he comes back. Changing jerseys for Austis, and he'll wear number 50.
We've got a foul whistled on the baseline.
Yeah, Jack Perry is going to be on Sam McLeod all night long when he's in.
Couple of entertaining games this afternoon as Huron picked up the victory for seventh place. And then it was Pierre picking up the consolation championship.
Ben Lauer, check that. No,
that's
Jack
Perry.
Yeah, that's going to be number two on him. With McLeod being very aggressive going into the paint.
And Luke Fritsch will come back into the lineup. Peary will take a chair.
And Fritsch most likely will be paired up against McLeod.
He did a nice job last night for the Knights off the bench, especially defensively.
Brad Drake back in for the Raiders. There's a shot there of head coach Ron Reichard. First year with the Stevens Raiders.
The man who coached Becky Hammond in high school. Into the front court, Braxton Elliott, 6'3 and a senior. Down low, Lauer turned around, saw a lane to the basket and took it. Fouls piling up here on the Knights.
Yeah, they can really slow down the flow of the game.
Ben Lauer picks up the foul. He's been in some foul trouble. That is the fifth team foul already on O'Gorman. Still 2.5 to play in the first quarter. The ball was tipped on the inbound. I think that might have been Fritsch. Elliott, front court. Directs traffic, covered by Drake.
Oh, that's going to be an offensive foul. Elliott got his arm around the back of the neck. Got that around Brad Drake, and they call the offensive foul.
Full court pressure here, as Brad Drake will bring it into the front court. Sixth. Jumper in the corner, no good. Weak side rebound, pulled down by Fritsch. John isn't real big, or Luke isn't real big, but he's plenty strong. Jumper on the way, up and good for Davis Cowan.
Had the height advantage, able to get off a real nice jump shot from the elbow. He's got 5 points. Yep, Fritsch is guarding McLeod. If you're Stevens, you want to get this to McLeod. That's a mismatch.
Mardian off Cunningham. The three put up by McLeod, no good. And Cowan with the rebound.
Sam is probably thinking, what do I got to do to get one to drop?
Allen up
just
and
like
good.
That.
Davis Cowan with 7 points here in the early going. Jumper, no good. Cowan, yet another rebound.
Stevens is 1 of 8 from the floor.
Ball stripped away. McLeod, offensive. Yep, offensive foul.
That's going to be his second foul, too. Coming for the Raiders, here it comes. Again, number 50 now is Wyatt Ostis.
Ostis is back into the lineup. Also, K.J. Watson and Mason Archambault.
Both these teams are going to keep us busy, Mike.
They are.
Everyone's going to get in the game tonight.
And the Knights going with their new five. Actually, just four, because Fritsch stays in there as part of this second five. Nice pass down low. Fritsch puts it up. No good. Mardian with the rebound. And the foul on O'Gorman.
Yeah, Fritsch trying to grab the ball. A little frustrating. That's one of those reactionary things. You miss the ball and you want to go back and get the ball after the missed shot.
Into the front court comes Archambault. Go back to Ostis. Brad Drake, the 5'10 senior. Stevens has had some games where they've been incredible this year, and they've had some others that were sort of head scratchers. Inconsistency has been the key word for their season. Shot put up, no good, and Antonio Cassiello with the rebound. Fritsch comes the other way, and he's going to be fouled.
KJ Watson trying to stay with Luke Fritsch.
Foul was whistled before the shot. Baseline jumper, no good. Tip, no good. Watson comes out with it. And that's how the quarter ends. The O'Gorman Knights on top of Rapid City Stevens. We're back with more after this timeout on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Davis Cowan, averaging 13 points a game in this tournament, has O'Gorman off to a good start as he's got the stroke down early. And the Knights will have the ball, leading 13-5.
First quarter stats for O'Gorman, 5 of 9 from the floor, 1 for 1 beyond the arc, 2 for 2 from the free throw line. And 7 turnovers in that first quarter.
Knights going with a bit of a combination of their lineup here. Davis Cowan and Lauer are both in there. Lauer will reverse it. The jumper on the elbow, no good. Rebound pulled down by one of my favorite players in the tournament, Xander Keene.
For Stevens, 1 of 10 from the floor. 1 of 7 beyond the arc. 0 for 4. Check that, 2 for 2 from the free throw line and 5 turnovers.
McLeod turns, faces up. Watson to Keene. Nice entry pass into Ostis. Shot no good, though, and here come the Knights. Quickly up ahead to Lauer. To the basket. Layup good.
And Lauer racing down the court.
He's been limited by foul trouble the last couple of nights.
Well, he was been bothered with a bad ankle here the last couple of weeks. Able to race down and beat Stevens down the other end.
Here comes Cowan the other way. Cowan. Foul whistled before the shot.
Archambault. Yeah, Archambault's going to get it for Rapid City Stevens. And a timeout by Ron Reichard. Rapid City Stevens.
This year, the South Dakota High School Activities Association added something to the state tournament at this location anyway. I'm not sure if it's at other locations. They've got an art show going on in the lobby. It's unbelievable the talent the wonderful artists that we have across the state of South Dakota that are in high school. They are just great, and as a matter of fact, I believe we're going to see a couple of awards from that given away tonight. Something different. I was talking with Wayne Carney earlier this evening, and he's saying the response to it has just been outstanding. And again, so much great art, none of which was submitted by Craig Maddock. As he's sitting here drawing a diagram as I'm actually telling you about that. Oh, my.
You will see no stick people.
No,
on the,
no.
On the art.
No. Stick figures frowned upon. So Rapid City Stevens has committed four team fouls. The lob in to Lauer. He'll get it to Braxton Elliott, who's back in the game. Elliott with one basket so far. He's been averaging 30 a game in the tournament. Oh, and a foul on Archambault.
Number two. You know, with the number of changes that we're going to see in this game, a lot of rotations, going deep on the bench. You know, we're going to see the system more than the player in this one, because the system is, it doesn't make a difference who is in the lineup. You go with the system, whether it's the Derek Roby system of their offense or the Ron Reichard system. We'll see a lot more of that show up in this game.
Antonio Cassiello back in the ball game. Goes to Elliott. Shot not there. Rebound McLeod. Brad Drake on the dribble. Gives it up to Keane, and Keane can't hit the layup.
Raiders are 8% from the floor.
Kick it back to Cowan. Cowan in the lane, puts it up and scores it. Davis Cowan having himself a night. He's got 9 here in the early going.
Using that lanky frame, a little taller than his defender, freeing him up to get that shot off without much of a problem.
Xander Keane will spin, give it back to McLeod. He'll rise up for the three, skips over the rim, no good. And Antonio Cassiello with the rebound up ahead. Layup up and good by Elliott.
What a great up pass. Skimmed right through it. Oh, and that's going to be the third on McLeod.
And so McLeod will check out. This is just about the time last night that he had to take a seat too, Craig, for the rest of the first half.
Well, he's been frustrated. The shots haven't been falling. That time he was pretty determined he was going to go to the rack.
And he even dropped the shoulder in the process. And Ron Reichard is letting him know about it. Jimmy Frank with the dribble. Pass goes to J.P. Costello, the sophomore.
He had a pretty good game last night.
Yeah, he did.
Knights lost a couple of their starters to fouls, and Costello was put into extra duty last night.
Foul goes on Xander Keane. Keane is 5'8", and a senior. He has pretty much one purpose, and that's to shoot threes, and he's really good at it. Free throw is no good as the Knights are in the bonus here the rest of the half. Here comes Brad Drake. Drake, the spin, no good. Rebound to the Knights. Up ahead it goes. Layup, no good. Jimmy Frank will step to the free throw line as he got hammered. Jimmy Burma. I said Jimmy Frank. I'm sorry about that. Jim Burma. Good heavens. Thank you. Jim Burma. I've only known him 17 years or so. Jim Burma. Steps up to the free throw line.
First appearance in the state tournament.
69% free throw shooter, and we'll step aside. O'Gorman with the early lead over Rapid City Stevens. And we're back after this on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. With Craig Maddock, I'm Mike Henriksen. O'Gorman out to the big early lead. Rapid City Stevens Raiders. Craig, what are they shooting from the floor?
It's 1 for 15. That is just over 6%. 1 of 8 beyond the arc. You know, they've tried to force it in. They got called for the offensive fouls a couple of times. Shots from the outside just haven't been going. You got to keep shooting, Mike.
Yep.
You know, if you're McLeod, of course, McLeod's not in. But you got Ostis in there. You got Cunningham in there.
Yeah, I think.
And Watson. Drake is one of the three-point shooters. And then Mardian as well.
Mardian on the right side. Looks inside for Ostis.
Someone's got to put the team on their shoulder and stop this streak and can one.
J.J. Cunningham. Mardian will drive. Reverse it out to J.J. Got it! His aunt and uncle in town from Lincoln, Nebraska are going to be ecstatic about that one. On the low block, that's Fritz. Outside to Burma. Burma reverses it over to Logan Harmelink, who is in the ball game.
Yeah, we're going to see everybody from the benches tonight.
The jump shot is up, no good. Kept alive into the hands of Costello, no good. And a rebound foul whistled. I think that's going to go on Fritch. It will go.
That's his second. Knights bring in Elliott, Lauer, Cowan, and Fleck.
Here come the Raiders. Brad Drake, the 5'10 senior, walks it into the front court. He's met there by Fleck. Cunningham. Watson hits the three. Craig, right on cue. You called it. Said they had to get some other guys involved in the offense. Back-to-back threes. Elliott reverses it. Cowan, the fall away, puts it up. Good defense that time by K.J. Watson.
Yeah, Cowan was challenged on his shot. And Cowan with the foul.
And Drake will step to the free throw line and shoot two. Of course, coming up at halftime of both games, they'll hand out the awards to the individuals, team members. Second game will have the Spirit of Sioux and the Spirit of Six awards. Back into the ball game is Cassiello.
Stevens is on a 7-0 run. Eight to nothing run.
Cassiello into the front court. Goes over to Fleck. Back to Elliott. Elliott crossover down the lane. He is hammered by Ostis. Wyatt Ostis will pick up the foul. Elliott misses.
He is 15 of 20 from the free throw line in the tournament.
81% free throw shooter on the season. Goes 0 for 2. Brad Drake back into the front court. K.J. Watson tries to feed it back to Ostis. Ball tipped away. Jump ball, alternating possession. It will stay with Rapid City Stevens.
Elliott was in there to help knock it away, and then all tied up.
Drake set to inbound. The run Cunningham behind a screen. Gonna call the timeout.
That's good D by O'Gorman.
It was. They recognized the play. And again, you mentioned the fact that this is the third time that they've played each other. So they're all of these teams at this level very, very familiar with each other. good job, though, by Brad Drake of keeping his head, too.
Rapid City Stevens has hit three threes, one of them from Cunningham. Another one came from Watson, back to back.
Yep.
The other three has come from Wyatt Ostis.
Yeah, that was the first basket of the game.
When he was number 32.
That's right, way back then. Yeah, if you're tuning in and you're familiar with the Rapid City Stevens, you're going, what's with Ostis? Or who's number 50? That is Ostis. He had some blood on his jersey, so they changed it. Raiders set to inbound once again. They'll get it into Watson. Back to Cunningham. Cunningham covered by Fleck.
See if they go to Ostis, because Lauer's on him.
Nice. Give and go. The layup. Oh, it just falls in. That was one I didn't think was going in, and it actually did.
10-0 run by the Raiders.
Elliott to Fleck. Nice lob pass down low. Well defended, though, by Watson. Elliott comes up with it in the corner. The shot clock reset there. Elliott puts it up and buries it.
Boy, we saw a lot of that last night. His first three of the night, he's got 7 points. Snaps that 10-0 run.
Ball corralled by Mardian. Mardian back to Cunningham.
Coaches are yelling, move, move, move the ball.
Entry pass into Ostis, and he's fouled by Lauer. Lauer went with the reach.
Picking up his second.
And J.P. Costello will be coming in for him. Stepping up to the free throw line is Wyatt Ostis. Wyatt, a 61% free throw shooter on the year.
1-for-2 in the tournament.
While we've got a moment, we want to thank the coaches for providing us the stats and information. A great group to work with, and we appreciate their help.
Stevens' shooting percentage has risen from 6 to 21%.
Skyrocketed.
Yeah, and they're two possessions out.
When it hits 30, sell. Elliott. Cowan. Double pumps. Good job by Watson. It's time they'll try to free up Elliott. Elliott to the basket. Offensive foul. Well, good defensive help by Brad Drake.
It was Drake. He was sitting right there on that low block and leaned into by Braxton Elliott. It'll be his second. Right now you got O'Gorman. You got four of the five starters, three of the five starters with two fouls.
Watson, inside pass was a little bit wide of Ostis, and Fleck brings it into the front court.
There's a lot of congestion in that lane with that pass.
Cowan puts it up, good, and one.
Cowan likes the shot from the elbow. Either side of the elbow, he loves that shot. Able to get up there.
He averaged 12 points a game during the season. He now has 13 in this game. He has 12 now, excuse me, 12. Into the front court. O'Gorman had a 15-point lead at 20-5. Raiders have heated up since that time. Mardian traveled. Andrew Mardian, 6'1 and a junior, committed to travel, so the Knights will have one more opportunity here. Shot clock is off. Back into the lineup is Antonio Cassiello.
Knights are 10 of 19 from the floor.
Knights, that's remember back in the old days before the shot clock, O'Gorman would wind the time down from as far as 90 seconds out, so killing the last 32 seconds is nothing. The drive, the kiss off the glass, up and good by Cassiello. Cunningham, the heave. No. And so at halftime, the O'Gorman Knights on top. A nice run there by Stevens, but the Knights with the lead, 28-17. We're back with some halftime hardware after this timeout.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Sports Championship is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Dakota Bank.
Halftime, third place game between Sioux Falls O'Gorman and Rapid City Stevens. Some hardware to be given out. Let's check in with the public address announcer, Jason Liu.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Please direct your attention to center court, where we will present awards to the teams that played this afternoon in the consolation game. Here to present the awards this evening, on behalf of the South Dakota High School Activities Association, our board of director members, Dr. Jason Uttermark, Sandy Klett, and Dan Whalen. Assisting with the awards and representing the association's corporate partners are Mike Begeman from Sanford Health, Jolene Smith from First Premier Bank, Premier Bank Card, Brian Hermanson from Farmers Union Insurance Agency, and Rachel Hegman from the South Dakota Army National Guard. The first team to receive their awards tonight are the eighth place team, the Arrows from Watertown. Team members are Nate Davis, Taylor Lindahl, Mikey Nichols, Alex Gower, Bailey Van Sickle, Landon Paul, Cole Workus, Nate DeSpiegler, Matt Decker, Hunter LaQuay, Marcus Hickman, Bryce LeBlanc, Brent Schulte, Spencer Wagey, Quade Peterson. Assistant coaches are Maddie Kranz, Pat McClemens, Sean Melmer, and Chris Tracy. Ladies and gentlemen, to receive the trophy for eighth place, head coach of the Watertown Arrows, Brian Norber. Our next team to receive their awards tonight is the team that finished in seventh place, the Tigers from Huron. Team members include Parker DeGene, Nemo Kaw, Houston Hines, Highland Hines, Trey Modig, Sam Carr, Mason Staley, Carter Brotherton, Greg Conrad, Riley Galen, Clay Corco, Ty Evers, Peyton Carr, Hayden Bush, Cole Corco, Alex Jimenez, Sam Kretschmar, and Brendan Cohen. Managers are Clay Kostel, Grace Schoenhar, Brianna Lichty, Quincy Gaylor, Mason Rozelle, and Tenley Buttenhagen. Assistant coaches are Bob DeBoer, John Scouting, and Eric Hall. Ladies and gentlemen, receiving the trophy for seventh place, head coach of the Huron Tigers, Tim Buttenhagen. Next up to receive their awards are the team that finished in sixth place, the Golden Eagles from Aberdeen Central. Team members include Cole Martins, Jesse Babcock, Nick Goman, Anthony Bachmeyer, Branston Meyer, Mason Trapp, Jacob Gary, Cannon Hannigan, Logan LeGrand, Gabe Swanson, Lane Teasing, Isaac Jones, Tevin Johnson, Cole Bergen, Lincoln Flaccus, TJ Ollum, and Brock DeGross. Team managers include Brooklyn Fouth, Andrew Berrigan, Adrian Schauneman, and Gabe Torbert. Assistant coaches are Mitch Trans, Trent Kurtz, Josh Mack, Mark Murphy, and Greg Murley. Ladies and gentlemen, to receive the sixth place trophy, head coach of the Golden Eagles, Brent Norberg. The Aberdeen Central Golden Eagles will have a welcome home celebration that will be at 4 p.m. Sunday in the common area at Aberdeen Central High School. Once again, a welcome home celebration for Aberdeen Central, 4 p.m. tomorrow in the commons area at Aberdeen Central. Our next team to receive their awards are our consolation champions, Pierre T.F. Riggs Governors. Team members include Charlie Anderson, Nick Rayburn, Aaron Severin, Brad Dean, Ethan Life, Trey Livermont, Daley Beck, Isaiah Watson, Max Seward, Max Booth, Clay Bush, Brevin Kaiser, and Joe King. Team managers include Brittany Fadul, Joanna Zanin, Colby Solberg, and Morgan Metzinger. Assistant coaches are Jeff Schleckaway and Scott Nye. Ladies and gentlemen, to receive the consolation champion fifth place trophy, head coach of the Pier TF Riggs Governors, Terry Becker. Congratulations to all team members of all tournament teams.
Congrats to those fine young men of the respective basketball teams. It's the third place game. O'Gorman with the lead over Rapid City. Stevens will get you to the start of the second half when we come back on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Championship event is brought to you in part by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Farmers Union Insurance, by SDN Communications, and by the Independent Insurance Agents of South Dakota.
It is halftime, and the O'Gorman Knights are on top, 28-17. They led by as many as 15 at 20-5.
Yeah, then Stevens went on a 10-0 run to get back in the ballgame.
Let's take a look at some of those first half highlights. Davis Cowan, he got O'Gorman off to a great start. Nice pass inside to Fritsch. Then a three-pointer by Ostis, back when he was wearing number 32. Lauer with the drive. Cowan, though, kept it up. Lauer with another layup, running the floor very nicely. Jumper in the lane by Cowan.
Nice pass.
Great pass ahead to Braxton Elliott. But then J.J. Cunningham with a big three, followed by K.J. Watson with another three.
Part of that 10-0 run.
Inside Brad Drake. The Braxton Elliott answered, as did Davis Cowan, and one. There's a little kiss off the glass.
Yes, yellow, that spin and move at the end of the first half.
So turnovers even, assists even, steals even, rebounds pretty even. But Craig, Rapid City Stevens shooting 21% from the floor.
Well, it was 6% at one time.
Yeah, they've heated up.
And O'Gorman has scored 10 points off of the 8 turnovers by Rapid City Stevens. Also, O'Gorman, 18 of their 28 points have come from inside the paint.
And so we are set to go with our second half of action. Again tonight, the championship game, Sioux Falls, Washington versus Sioux Falls, Lincoln.
One change for the O'Gorman Knights here, Mike, for the start of the second half. Cassiello will get the start, along with Elliott, Cowan, Peary, and Lauer. Jacob Fleck got the start for the game, but Cassiello will start here in the second half. Rapid City Stevens, they'll also go with their starters, Drake, Archambault, Cunningham, McLeod, and Ostis.
O'Gorman will have the ball to start. Inbounding it, Jack Peary, who sat out quite a bit of that first half with foul trouble. Cowan inside to Lauer. Lauer working on Ostis, muscles his way up. Well played by Ostis. Lauer got the rebound, can't convert. And McLeod, who checked out with 5.5 minutes to play in the first half with his third foul, gets the rebound.
Ostis did a good job there.
Archambault got into no man's land and had nothing to do with it. Elliott, the run out, the finger roll, and two.
10 for Elliott.
Mason Archambault comes into the front court. Man-to-man defense. Both teams have gone pretty straight man. We haven't seen much zone in this entire tournament. J.J. Cunningham puts it on the floor, goes with the left hand, just can't spin it in. Good effort by J.J. That's one thing he's going to always give you is great effort. Elliott thought about it, instead gets it back on the give and go. Great pass from Jack Peary. O'Gorman has good size. I think it was 6'3", 6'6", 6'5", 6'6". Shot up, no good. McLeod, the put back up and good.
Sam did a good job going after the shot. Was in the right place with the loose ball and converted.
Was that his first basket of the night?
Yes.
Wow.
Total of 4 points.
Averaging 21 on the evening, or on the year. Jump shot up, no good. McLeod with the rebound. Archambault leaves it off to Ostis for two. Much better decision by the sophomore, Mason Archambault. Elliott, he'll work the perimeter. Cassiello is held.
And if that's on Archambault, that would be three. And that is on Mason. So now McLeod and Archambault, three fouls apiece.
One of our officials tonight, the one that called that, Jeremy Grady. You know how you go to those golf tournaments and they have the hole-in-one competitions for a car? Shot no good. And how nobody ever wins one of those? Well, Jeremy Grady did a couple of years ago. McLeod for three, got that one. A little layup, opened things up for him, and he hits his first three-pointer.
His third three of the tournament. Left all alone, and McLeod has picked up number four.
McLeod will check out. KJ Watson, the 6'3 junior, will check into the lineup. Free throw is up and good. Second free throw on the way.
First free throws for the tournament for Jack.
O'Gorman with the 10-point lead. They've led by as many as 15. They led it 28-17 at half.
Now the Raiders went on that 10-0 run when McLeod was out of the lineup. They were getting three-point shots.
Watson can't get that one to fall. Elliott will bring it into the front court. Knight's going to go with their line change here with five new players in a moment. Three is up and good.
That's his second three of the game.
Braxton Elliott now with 14 points on the night. Watson gives it off to Brad Drake. Ball loose on the floor. Ostis picks it up. Drake will reset. Cunningham, Archambault, Ostis, Cunningham, Drake, or Archambault, excuse me, wide right, and we'll step aside. O'Gorman with the lead on Stevens in the third place game at the State AA Boys Basketball Tournament in Sioux Falls. With Craig Maddock from KWSN, Sioux Falls Sports Radio. I'm Mike Henriksen. O'Gorman got out to the big lead and has pretty much maintained it.
Turnover for the Knights, that will be number 9 of the game.
Archambault walks into the front court. It's been nice seeing his dad, Russ, here at the tournament. Russ looks like he can still play. The three up by Ostis, no good, and Fritsch with the rebound. As O'Gorman now goes with Jacob Fleck, Jimmy Burma. Burma puts it up, no good. Rebound by Ostis. Archambeau drives through traffic, puts it up, no good, but he is fouled.
There's a bunch of grabbing going on there.
Blue number 10, that's Jacob Fleck, who will pick up the foul. McLeod checking back into the lineup with four fouls. But at the same time, when you're down 13 with 3 minutes left to go in the third period, I think Ron Reichard is figuring we got nothing to lose here.
Here he goes.
And he scores immediately upon getting into the game.
He's got nine.
Up ahead to Ethan French.
Raiders will stay in that man-to-man as Costello is going to get fronted by McLeod. Breezing right by him, though, is French.
Nice drive. Here come the Raiders the other way. Archambeau. Chris James, K.J. Watson. Archambeau uses the screen, drives, has it blocked. Nice defensive play by J.P. Costello, the 6'5 sophomore with the block.
And it came right off of Costello, or rather Watson, or yeah, Archambeau, and it's going to go right back to the O'Gorman Knights.
Yeah, so O'Gorman subs in another five players back to their starting lineup.
Yeah, it's good to see a few of the extra kids in the game as Cowan hits it from his favorite shot. His favorite spot on the floor, the elbow.
Davis Cowan having himself a dandy night. Archambeau around to James, no good. Rebound, McLeod with the left hand up and good. Sam's big sister plays at the University of South Dakota. USD still alive in the women's WNIT.
Heading out to Colorado.
Yep. The jumper by Elliott, up and good.
17 for Elliott.
Callen with 14 on the night. Archambeau uses the screen, goes baseline and scores it. Nice job. Again, just a sophomore.
As picks up his first basket of the game.
As his court sense improves, he's just going to be fun to watch. He can be electric. We saw that in the first game when he went scoreless in the first half and scored 16 in the second half. Davis Cowan working on Watson. Muscles his way to the basket. Watson blocked it out of bounds. It will stay with the Knights. Mardian, Keene, and Ostis come back into the lineup for the Raiders.
Every bit of that 6'3 frame by Watson stretching out to knock it away.
Lauer with the ball. Keene matched up at 5'8. Nice crossover and a foul whistled. Mardian came over with the help defense on the entry pass to Lauer. He commits the foul.
Just the third team foul on the Raiders.
Inbound pass, Cowan, no good. Rebound to Ostis. Wyatt Ostis, 6'6 and a senior. The pass.
Those kind of things drive coaches nuts.
Yes, they do.
That would be the 10th turnover for the Raiders.
And that one essentially unforced. It was 28-17 at halftime. O'Gorman has led by as many as 15 points. Cowan leaves it off for Lauer, drives baseline, reverse, and scores it.
I think you switched hands even underneath the basket.
That was an excellent move by Big Ben Lauer. He's 6'6 and a junior, coming back next year. The steal by Braxton Elliott, the run out and two. Averaging 30 points a game in the tournament. He had 25 the first night. He had 35 in that double overtime loss last night.
Certainly is going to be on the all-tournament team, but if you're going to have an MVP,
Archambeau,
Braxton Elliott's name would absolutely be there.
Watson, better get it off, partially blocked, and that's how we end the third period. O'Gorman on top and in control in the third place game. We're back with the fourth quarter after this timeout on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. So great to have you joining us on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. With Craig Maddock, I'm Mike Henriksen. The boys' AA tournament third place game. Xander Keene covered, gets it off to McLeod, scores it.
He's got 13.
Well, we are starting to see the glimpses of how he averaged 21 points a game during the regular season. Pull-up jumper on the elbow, no good. Rebound, Archambault. Up ahead to McLeod. McLeod in the open court. Had the ball stripped away by Fritsch. Watson gets it back, though, and scores the bucket.
Five for KJ.
A little organized chaos right there. On the dribble, that's Logan Harmeling for O'Gorman. Jimmy Burma.
For some of these kids, only 7 minutes left of their high school basketball career.
Burma had one boil out. McLeod up ahead to Keene. Layup and one.
I don't know how Xander did it, but at 5'8", he was able to squeeze right through there on the layup.
A nice pass, and he gets it up over the big boys. Specifically, J.P. Costello. Keene mostly just shoots threes. He's not a run the court and hit the layup guy.
First trip to the free throw line.
That is his first miss this year at the free throw line. He was shooting 100% coming in. Cowan tries to cross over on Watson. Goes back to Cassiello. Drive by Elliott, high off of the square. Just the right amount of English to spin it in. Keene down low. Entry pass and a foul whistle. That's going to go on Jack Peary. For Jack, that's his third. Third O'Gorman team foul. Stevens has also committed three. McLeod, front of the rim, no good. Ostis the rebound. Archambault for three. Too strong. Watson keeps it alive. McLeod comes up with it, muscles it up, and scores it.
15 for McLeod. Score update on Braxton Elliott. One of those threes has been a two, so he's got 20 points now tonight.
Lauer on the baseline. With the left hand, up and good.
Wow.
Ben showing us some offense that we haven't seen in the previous nights of the tournament.
You have a big guy who can do that with the left hand and the right hand. And with finesse.
Yep.
That's pretty good.
There's the drive up and score it for Jack Peary. 6'5 and a junior. He'll be back next year. Archambault to Watson. Back to McLeod. And McLeod is going to be fouled. He will walk to the line right at the 5 minute mark. Braxton Elliott whistled for the foul. JJ Cunningham and Brad Drake will check back into the lineup.
I think we're going to see a pretty up-tempo type ball game here the rest of the way. A lot of shots going to go up.
I think so.
5 minutes left of the year.
I don't know. The Knights can be pretty disciplined. Into the front court and a carrying violation. So we'll step aside. The final 4:50 to play here in the third place game when we get back on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. With Craig Maddock, I'm Mike Henriksen.
Update, Rapid City Stevens being led in scoring by Sam McLeod. He has 17.
Raiders have this down to just a 13-point lead. Archambault, McLeod, skips over the rim. Weak side rebound pulled down by Cassiello.
Leading scorer for the Knights, Braxton Elliott, 21. Check out 20 points tonight.
Cassiello is fouled on his drive. And Jacob Fleck, the senior, will check back in. That is the fourth team foul. So again, a couple of fouls away from either team shooting. The one and one. Inbound, Cowan, guess what he's gonna do? Oh, he missed that one badly, but.
McLeod stepped out of bounds. Well, I'm starting to see a lot of orange and white invade the arena for the championship tonight with Washington and Lincoln.
Lauer faces up, and he'll take the jumper. That time, Ostis was backed off of him, anticipating the drive, which he's done the last few times. So Lauer just squares up, hits the jumper. Drake. Covered by Elliott, cross court, Cunningham. A step through, back to Drake for the open three. No. Wyatt Ostis runs it down. He and Perry jump ball, alternating possession. It will belong to the O'Gorman Knights. Yeah, good crowd on hand tonight. Of course, they won't let the respective students into the student section until this game is over. Nice no-look pass. Cowan with the bucket. Lauer with the assist. Back up to a 15-point lead. Archambault, the long three, got it. And a timeout called by Ron Reichard, the head coach of Rapid City Stevens Raiders. Again, we'd like to thank the folks at South Dakota Public Broadcasting, the men and women that have been running the cameras, a lot of the students working the cameras for us in our state tournaments, the men and women in the truck doing the graphics, the directing, the sound, all of the things that go into putting on a telecast. They do an excellent job, and Craig and I are just delighted once again to have the opportunity to work with South Dakota Public Broadcasting. O'Gorman will have the basketball. Full court pressure here by the Raiders.
Davis Cowan for the Knights with a double-double. He's got 11 boards, 16 points.
Elliott to Cowan. Around on the right side to Fleck. And yeah, O'Gorman gonna eat some clock here. Peary puts it on the floor. He's fouled by Cunningham. Cunningham kind of grabbed him as he was going past. So JJ will pick up the foul.
Well, Mike, a year from now, it's going to be AA boys and girls combined here at the Denny Sanford Premier Center.
Yeah, we'll have two champions that night, two championship games.
Ostis with the rebound. How many has he got? He's got 6 rebounds, 7 points tonight.
Archambault pulls up, too strong. Fleck with the rebound. Elliott, triple teamed, had to pick up his dribble. Raiders playing hard.
Yeah, they're not quitting. They're
nope.
Still
13
hustling.
Points, 2.5 minutes to go. Elliott, right-handed layup, up and good. Braxton Elliott has 22 points. Archambeau, it's over for McLeod for three, skips over the rim, rebound, and a foul. Davis Cowan got the rebound. JP Costello checks into the lineup. Also,
Charlie Ill.
So Ill into the ball game. Elliott. Cowan. Nice pass on the baseline. They'll give it over to Costello. He missed it. Got it back. Oh. No good, but he'll step to the line and shoot two.
I'm just taking a look here with Braxton Elliott. He has scored 83 points in this tournament.
What's the tournament record?
Most points in a championship round in three games is 89 by Jared Hannigan.
Oh, okay. And how many does Braxton have?
83.
Rebound controlled by Cunningham.
Most points in the tournament, including consolation play.
Yep.
Eric Klein. Back in 1991 with Aberdeen Central, 114 points. That's, 114.
That's just crazy. Pull up jumper, no good. Ball will go out of bounds. And all the way down the hallway. Nope, McLeod must have saved it, tipped it back. McLeod went all the way down the hallway at the end of the Premier Center here.
Eric Klein's got a lot of records, by the way, in this Double-A basketball tournament.
No surprise.
Most points in a first-round game with 41. Consolation play one game, 47.
The tip is up and no good. O'Gorman not exactly closing this out, but Stevens not taking advantage of their opportunities. Archambeau double pumps and threw it just a bit high for Sam McLeod.
Well, Gorman fans will remember back in 2004 at the state tournament semifinals. Semifinal game, Mitch Begeman threw down 38 for the most in a semifinal. Now, some extra players coming in for the Knights with a minute to go. As coming out was Davis Cowan, the senior, getting a nice hand. Timeouts being called to bring in some extra players. Well, when you look at the O'Gorman Knights, Elliott, Fleck, Cowan, three seniors on that ball club.
Right, but you have to like the fact that you've got Fritsch, Cassiello, you got J.P. Costello, Jimmy Burma, a lot of guys coming back.
And for Rapid City Stevens, they had they got Brad Drake, J.J. Cunningham, Sam McLeod, Wyatt Ostis, Chris James, and Alexander Keene.
So Mason Archambeau, K.J. Watson, and Andrew Mardian. Those are the three that have contributed, the three underclassmen that have contributed here in this tournament. They will leave Elliott in. I imagine he will sub in.
Coach Roby said they're not going to foul.
Jumper on the way, no good. Rebound pulled down.
Well, Jacob Fleck apparently didn't get the message. But
I think they actually did foul so that Burma can come in and Elliott can take a seat.
What a career for Braxton Elliott. Finishes with 83 points in the tournament. And for the Stevens Raiders, they bring Ostis out. They bring McLeod out. Fleck comes out for O'Gorman. All the seniors getting their due here tonight.
Let's see. Bennett Fierro is in the lineup for Stevens. Taylor Schultz Taylor Schultz looks like he checked in from 1974. I love that look. There's a drive by Reed Brost. The jumper put up no good. And the rebound. Up ahead, back to Jimmy Verma, and Jimmy is going to dribble out the game. So congratulations to the O'Gorman Knights as they will pick up third place in the 2015 state tournament held here at the Premier Center in Sioux Falls. And a nice job by the Rapid City Stevens Raiders. Win in the opening round and then finished fourth. What a career for McLeod. Nice job by them. Ron Reichard took over the head coaching job in a tough situation. Derek Boos got hired late to take over the Roosevelt program when Lee Taylor left there to go to Augustana. So Ron and his staff did a nice job. And Craig Maddock is standing by with the head coach of the O'Gorman Knights, Derek Roby.
Coach, congrats, third place game. What was your idea with this game? You've got a lot of players in the game tonight.
Well, probably too many the first half because we were out of rhythm the whole time. That was my fault, but you know what? All these kids deserve it. They're great kids. You know, I'd call them all my sons. I love them to death. And, you know, they all deserve to be in that game. It's one of those games where I told the kids, I said, you know what, let's end on a positive. Win, lose, or draw, we're going to have a lot of fun. We're going to check a lot of kids in and let them experience the thrill of a state tournament. Really proud of our guys.
Elliott and Cowan had a huge tournament for you.
They really did. I mean, what can you say about Braxton Elliott? He just took over games for us, and obviously he'll be on the all-tournament team, I'm assuming. Maybe Davis will too. I don't know. I hope so. But, you know, they both had great years for us, great careers for us. You know, Braxton scored in the top five for us at our school all time. I mean, that's the type of year he had. Davis as well, you know, and then let's not forget about Jacob Fleck. Love that kid.
Congratulations, the voice. You kept the voice stayed with you, didn't it?
Oh, sure, sure.
Congratulations out there.
Much. Thanks
you
for
got
me.
It, Coach.
Thank you.
You bet. Derek Roby, head coach of the O'Gorman Knights. They get third place. And Mike, we get ready for the championship. Lincoln and Washington.
As you see the migration of students into the Washington section for students, Sioux Falls Lincoln with similar numbers down on their end of the floor. This place is gonna get loud. We'll be back to wrap up that first game and to get you ready for the championship right after this timeout on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Sports Championship is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Dakota Bank. Statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Championship event is brought to you in part by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Farmers Union Insurance, by SDN Communications, and by the Independent Insurance Agents of South Dakota.
Welcome back to the Premier Center, about to host its first state high school championship game. But first of all, let's look back at the third place game, some second half highlights and statistics from that O'Gorman win. Nice drive by Braxton Elliott with the little finger roll. Then the great dish inside to Elliott. Sam McLeod finally was able to get free. A good dish there from Archambault to Ostis. McLeod with the three, but Elliott answers with the three of his own. The drive by McLeod up and good. Then the drive in. Nice drive by Ethan French. Cowan with a nice game tonight. He was outstanding. McLeod did everything he could to try to keep Stevens in it in the second half, but Every time they got within 8 or 10 or so, O'Gorman would answer. Mason Archambault. There's a nice drive by Lauer. McLeod with another bucket. Good job by KJ Watson along the baseline. The hanger and the English off the glass by Elliott. Lauer with the layup. And if you think you're seeing an awful lot of inside shots, you're right. There's Cowan. Now, Archambault did hit a three. But then the drive by Elliott. Taking a look at the stats, Craig, all those layups that you saw, that's how O'Gorman was able to shoot 25 for 49.
38 of the 59 points came in the paint.
That figures to 48% field goal shooting. Otherwise, a lot of things pretty even. O'Gorman only took 5 threes, but it was O'Gorman claiming third place. We'll step aside once again when we come back. We'll set up the championship game as you get a look at the Sioux Falls Lincoln student section. They went with the whiteout tonight. We're back with more on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Sports Championship is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Dakota Bank.